This is a WVTM 13 editorial with President and General Manager Susanna Schuler.
We have much to do in this winter of peril and significant possibilities. Much to repair, much to restore, much to heal, much to build, and much to gain. Those were the words of our 46th president, Joseph R. Biden, as he took the oath of office on Wednesday. No question he begins this new role at a time of incredible division and too much hate across our country. Yet this president isn't the first to face division and pledge unity as cornerstone to his action plan. On his inauguration in 1801, Thomas Jefferson said, "Let us then, fellow citizens, unite with one heart and one mind. Let us restore to social intercourse that harmony and affection without which liberty and even life itself are but dreary things." In 1989, George H.W. Bush said, "The American people await action. They didn't send us here to bicker. They ask us to rise above the merely partisan." Each president enters office with tremendous challenges and promises. Our promise to you is WVTM 13 will hold this administration and our Alabama leaders accountable for the promises they've made in their election runs. I also challenge each of us to absorb some of the many memorable words shared as part of this historical four-year ritual and pledge ourselves to be part of the solution. None were more beautifully presented than those of the nation's youngest poet laureate, Amanda Gorman. At 22, she inspires a nation to see the light and be the light.
"When day comes, we step out of the shade, aflame and unafraid. The new dawn blooms as we free it. For there is always light, if only we're brave enough to see it, if only we're brave enough to be it."
This has been a WVTM 13 editorial. If you would like to reply, please send an email to this address.